Good morning, everyone, and please be seated. Well, happy Trinity Sunday. This is the one Sunday when we give ourselves permission to try to figure out what the heck it we mean by the Trinity. When we say the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, do we worship three people, one person? That's what we try to discover on Trinity Sunday. I was just looking at this collect. It says, to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and in the power of your divine majesty to worship the unity. Now, if you're not confused by that, I don't know who is. This is the day when we give ourselves permission to figure out and to think about what we call God. Do we call God Father? Do we call God Creator when we listen to that unbelievable story of creation? Do we call God Jesus the Son? Do we call God the Holy Spirit? In your heart of hearts, what is it that you call God? It's somewhat like that Buddhist parable when an elephant wandered into a village and three blind men went up to him, up to the elephant, and said, well, an elephant is like a wall, because this blind man had been up against the girth of an elephant. The other blind man said, no, an elephant's very much like a tree, because that blind man had been touching the leg of the elephant. And the third blind man said, no, an elephant is like a rope, because that blind man had been carrying on, had been pulling on, if you will, the tail of the elephant. There are some people who think that Matthew actually added this part to Jesus' words in the final words that Jesus said. When Matthew says, go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. When Matthew was writing this gospel, it was thought to have been about 150 years after Jesus had died. And the early Christian church was having a real problem trying to describe who God was. The Jewish friends, those that were trying to talk and explain who Jesus was, said, well, you're worshiping three gods. But the Romans and the Greeks were saying, oh, well, actually, we're very comfortable because you're worshiping three gods. And so Matthew was trying to say, we're worshiping one God with three names. So what they did was come up with this kind of emergency doctrine of the Trinity. Tom Long calls it this bridge that they built in the middle of the battle to try to get over the river. It's kind of that emergency pontoon bridge. They were kind of saying, we believe it, and this is kind of how we explain it. We believe in the Trinity. And that was just the beginning. Many, many wars have been fought over what do we call God? What do we call the nature of God? Is it three? Is it one? In our hearts of heart, you call God what you call God. And you call God whatever that is when you have met God. Jesus was saying to the disciples and to us, go out and make more disciples. But you have to be a disciple to make more. And as a disciple, we are students, perpetual interns. We are always trying to figure out who this God is and what we believe in our hearts. And sometimes we go one way, sometimes we go another. But as we create in ourselves discipleship, And as we try to explain to others how we call God, the most important thing is how you know God. When is it that you knew and felt God's love? Was it the Creator God? Was it the God when you saw the sunrise this morning or the sun on the water? Was that the God that you felt closest to? Or was it the God of Jesus? Jesus who showed us the love and compassion, forgiveness of our God. Is that how you know God? Or is it the power of God, the Spirit of God? That power that gives us that ability to go one more step. I was talking to some of the teachers who have finally finished the school year. And they felt in their heart of hearts that last moment, that last end of the race, if you will, when only the Holy Spirit helped them get across the finish line and get those kids out. It's that power within us when we're faced with someone who we have a bit of a problem with, and we feel that sense of forgiveness and love. It's that the God, the power of God that you know in your heart of hearts. This is the day when we give ourselves permission to dwell in that ambiguity, if you will. When is it that you knew God? Write it down. Remember it. Because today is the day we will anchor our faith, if you will. So if somebody turns to you tomorrow and says, tell me about your God. You have words and experiences to be able to share it. You can go out and make those disciples. And I'm not saying that discipleship means that you have to proclaim that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, and there is no other way. But what I'm saying is that the discipleship is when you tell people about the God of creation, the God of love, the God of power. When you yourselves in your lives make other people disciples because you act like a disciple. When you in your heart of hearts knows the God of love, the God of creation, the God of power. That's how we make disciples. It's when we ourselves are discipleship. And feel free to tell others and tell yourself you have no idea what you call God in the end of ends. Because the greatest theologians, the seminarians, everyone isn't quite sure what we mean by the doctrine of the Trinity. But in our conundrum and in our confusion, we do know the final words that Jesus said to us, which was, and remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. Even in our great confusion, if you will, we know that God is with us always. Amen.
Amen.